today I'm going
Recording has started.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for tuning into our October 24th creativity workshop here from the Adobe Education team. For those who I haven't met, my name is Clara Galland. So I lead our educator community programs here at Adobe for primary, secondary, and higher education. And today I'm thrilled to be joined by Karen, who is one of our amazing Adobe Education leaders. She's been an educator for 10 years in the Netherlands, and she's an artist by nature. She also has her own freelance company where she can create art as her passion, like community art projects and for the local municipality. So thank you, Karen, so much for joining us, and I'll hand it off to you.
Yeah, thank you, Clara. Today I'm going to show you a little bit of Illustrator Draw, a little bit of Adobe Capture. We're going some crazy stuff with patterns made with Capture and how you can use them, color schemes, how I kept my colors from images and send them through to my desktop. So it all be going to be Creative Cloud and libraries. And we're going to switch. We make a start of a drawing, but because of the time, I have made a whole sketch layout, and we're going to send it to the computer. And then I'm going to give you some tricks how you can fill in the empty spaces and what you can do with the patterns and colors. So yeah, let's go and start right away. I shared my iPhone. I'm still saving for an iPad. Luckily, I'm not there yet. So I'm drawing on my iPhone, and it's small. I will show you. So it's an iPhone 5. And now I'm hoping that I don't have to press any code. Here you can see I have entered my sketch, and you see the So I will start with a new project. And if you can see, I have not much space on my iPhone to draw, so I use a little cheap stylus because my fingers are too big to draw. And I'm going to place my image, and it's an image that I always get on paper. I'm always drawing somewhere, and I take a picture of it. I will show you the complete drawing on paper. This one. I hope you can see it. But today we are only going to sketch the butterfly. So going to my... Oh, I'm sorry. My Illustrator draws in Dutch, and I can't get it in English. So I will tell you what what I see. I will try to translate it, but I will enter an image, and it's on my iPhone. So I've made a little album for this workshop, and here you can see my sketch, and then I take it to make it fit the screen. And it doesn't matter how big you are sketching, because you can, it's all vector, so afterwards you can scale it up on your laptop, but it's okay. So I've discovered a little bug, by the way, because I wanted to rotate it. So if you click on the image layer, here you see transform, and normally now I can rotate. Early on, it didn't work. I didn't understand why. But you see, luckily I had some practice. Now it does work, so I'm happy now. And I will bring down my layer. So on the next layer, we're going to sketch, and there are beautiful pencils. Is everybody familiar with Illustrator Draw or not? I'm curious for the one who are interpreting the workshop. Are you all familiar with Illustrator Draw? I see some chats for me. All right. Okay. Over here, you can see the brushes, and I will take a brush and a brush size, and if you go up, it's going up. If it's going down, your brush is taking smaller. Because I have a lot of detail, I am sketching with a small brush, the option of the brush, so you can make it more transparent or full, and of course the color. Now I'm taking my brush, start here, and because of the small screen, I have to do something. Over here you can temporarily hide all your stuff so you can draw. And now you can scale it up and start somewhere and start drawing. So sometimes my finger, I'm starting drawing already, but that's not very. So you can see it takes time to sketch, and I'm not sketching it very very good right now. I'm a little bit of shaking, sorry, but normally I will take some time, and maybe I turn around. You can see how I sketch. I turn around my iPhone in the position I want and then scale it up. And because it's a small screen, it's difficult, but you can manage to follow the lines with a little stylus. Okay, I won't sketch the whole drawing because then you don't see as much as I want to see, but maybe only this section. Okay, if you have made a sketch, I want to use some colors, and now we're going to Adobe Capture, and the Capture, it's a great app. I use it for colors, I use it for everything. Here you can see I search for some images that are source images to use for colors. So I'm going to my images, going to my workshop, and here you can see images that I collect from Instagram or Facebook or something else. So beautiful artwork from other people. I only wanted to use the color scheme of the artwork. So if I'm taking the zebra, if you want to work it well, then you have to crop it before you use it. Then you don't have the Instagram layout, because he used that one as well for your color scheme, but I think it's nice. So it's a great way to start, and you can make your own colors and schemes, and you can save them to your iCloud. So if you are finished, so it's in my library now, and I can make a name for it. So and then if I'm going to my Illustrator, all the colors are in my library. So if I go to my swatch panel and I go I'm having it here to my library, here you can see Karen. And all the colors are from source images I found from Instagram or Facebook, and I'm collecting them to use. And if you want to use them in your Illustrator document, then you have to right click, add team to swatches, and you can use them right away. So that's very handy. If you're not very common with color schemes and you have troubles to find the right colors, using an image as color base is always the right way to go. Collect them, but you can do much more with Captivate. So I'm going back to my iPhone again, because you can make some patterns as well, and you won't believe it, but these are patterns from old cell phone cards, because my father is selling them. You can see it here. They're all old cell phone cards and stamps that I use for patterns. So I will do it live, maybe with an Italian cell phone card. I will make a picture from it and then you can see what I'm doing. In the top you can choose for bitmap pattern or for vector pattern. I like the vector one, but then it freezes. Okay, let's use this one. You can rotate it and it's almost a seamless pattern, so you don't have to worry about anything. You just play around, scale it up and down, maybe go back because you have different patterns. In the right, you can choose if you want tiles, if you want like this one. So you can go crazy with some patterns and you can start right away. So I've collected some patterns over here and I will show you what I'm doing to use them in my artwork. You can make a 3D from your pattern as well. I didn't know that, but it's crazy. So it's, yeah, I think it's the best app Adobe has. So, okay, on the iPhone. Okay, I'm ready. I go back to my Illustrator draw. I finished my sketching and now I wanted to send it. You can make a time lapse after all. You can see what you were doing. I want to show you that. Here you have some shapes that you can use if you want standard shapes or rulers or something like that. But you can make a time lapse. I will show you because it's great and you can see what you were doing and it automatically make a time lapse of your drawing process. You can see I made a lot of mistakes on a small iPhone before it was right. So you can share that as well, that you are, have proof that you've made this artwork and you can make a tutorial out of it. Whatever you want. So great, great app. Great future as well. But I'm going to send it to my computer. I'm going to send it to Illustrator again. I've already sent it. Here it is, straight from my iPhone, right to Illustrator, and you can go crazy. But I will show you something. If you are in your Illustrator project, you can see the drawing, the image that was laying beneath. So I turned the layer off, of course. And here you can see the sketching part. The only thing that I find a little bit disappointing is that it's like a blob brush, so it's all filling and not strokes. So that's a bit difficult to change the thickness of the fillings. It's far more work than when they are strokes. But you can work around that, but I don't go to show it right now. But yeah, with offset path, and you can change it back and forth and make it thicker or thinner. But it's difficult. But also another thing, I didn't color the inside, so I can't color all the things. Of course, I can make a live paint right out of it, but then it changes because these are fillings. So I don't know what live paint is going to do. I'm not a crazy fan about live painting. So what am I going to do? It's a trick that I'm using. You don't have to use it. I'm only going to show you because I think it's working fine for me. So I make a duplicate of my layer. This one is the backup. Maybe I want the black lines in front. I don't know yet, but for certain I insurance, I duplicate the layer. And in the second layer beneath, I draw a rectangle. Then I'm going to select all of it, so, and go to my Pathfinder. Oh, it was already there. And then I'm going to separate it. Or you can choose minus the back. Whatever you want is possible. After that, you can change individual all the stuff you're working on. Now we're going back to the swatches again. A team. I don't know if I'm going to. Okay. Well, I was one step too far, I think. Let's do it again. I'm sorry. Ungroup. And I'm going to color the background because otherwise I don't know what I'm doing. But this is not as difficult as well. I used another feature earlier on and I will show you. And that was minus the back. And I like that future. So, if I color it now, now I can see what I'm doing. And you can start painting and coloring all the stuff in. I will show you how I use the patterns. Maybe I want to color this one. And of course, I like to color that one as well. So select all the. And now I'm going to make a copy out of it. And in the copy, I will use a pattern that I make. So I'm going to my own library, going to the knee, and here are my cell phone patterns I made earlier on. Just pick one, and it will automatically place it into your fillings. But I want to scale it. So with my right mouse button, I'm going to transform scale. And if you clicked, unclick the transform object, then you are able to make it larger. So if you want to use it or make it smaller, but now there are more inside, so it's the opposite. Maybe the other one. Okay, let's try it out. Make it bigger. And now you can see the vintage of the, because this was a pattern of the stamp, you can see the stamp already. And I like that kind of stuff, like vintage kind of addings to it. So, but now I'm going to the blending and the transparency and going to set the blending mode, whatever you want, and try to figure out which one is the best to use.
And Karen, we have a quick question.
Yes.
So Craig is asking, you know, which app are you using to show your iPhone on the screen? And what are some of the shortcuts that you're typing?
I'm using QuickTime. I will show you how I show my iPhone. If you go over here, you can go to a new film record. And then you can choose, wait, I will stop. This one, you go over here, then you can choose your iPhone. Oh yay, but now it's not connecting anymore. So like that, and then you can show what you are doing, and you can in the same way you can show your iPad or anything else. So it's a quick way, and it's a trick I learned from the edX course. So happy to show you. And the other question was?
And the shortcuts that you're using. Is there a resource to access those shortcuts? And you can share at the end too, if you want to continue with this.
Which shortcuts do you want? Because there are a lot of shortcuts. Oh, I know. For the copy and paste in front, I think.
Mm-hmm.
All right. If you have an object like this, I will give it just a color. And you want to copy it and place it in the same spot, just Command C or Control C and Command F or Control F, and it will make a copy on the right on the same spot. Easy trick. I always use that one. So, because now you can add blending modes to the one in front or anything else. So use that a lot.
Great, thank you.
Okay. Of course, you can make some textures as well with your cell phone. Maybe we want to make a texture. Let's make a texture of it. I will. Just, of course, textures, just make a photo. But I want to tell you, use everything you got from records, old vintage, cover up, everything you can use to make new art with it and digital art. Okay, send it to. Oh, I will share it. What I'm doing. I don't know if everybody is using AirDrop, but I like AirDrop. So let's send it straight to the computer. I just clean up, so I was prepared. Normally it's full. okay. Ah. I don't know where this is going to end. I'm just showing you some stuff, and I hopefully you're going to like it. I always use a lot of blending modes. You can see over here. Normally I don't do it in Illustrator. Normally I filled in all the gaps and all the objects in Illustrator, and maybe the patterns, I'm already placed them into Illustrator, and then I go to Photoshop, and in Photoshop I'm using, of course, all the textures and extra options to make it a bit more wow. Maybe I can show you something else I've drawn with the iPhone for some inspiration. I'll show you the finished project, and I will take you to the steps I've taken. This one was drawn on the iPhone as well. You saw it earlier at Bump, but this one was drawn on the iPhone as well. And here you can see the screenshots of the app. Here you can see it in Illustrator. Finishing, this is how I end in Illustrator, where everything is filled in. And then I'm going to, then I go to Photoshop, and you can see it by PSB. It's a large document, and then you choose, of course, another extension for it. It's a big file, maybe. I don't know if my... Just make you through the process. So I start off on the iPhone, but I did fillings on the iPhone as well, also in Illustrator Draw. So normally I'm going to fill in the colors as well in on the app, but now I don't have the time to color in the butterfly, so I will do it later. And then on my computer, I go for the extras and the extra options and whatever I can do with it. Okay.
Karen, I love this. This is really interesting to see, and I keep thinking about you know, students in the classroom. There's so many kind of different objects that they could be able to take photos of and then turn into a pattern. So I'm sure there are a lot of different examples and possibilities from their illustrations as well.
Yeah, you can, and everybody is using the iPhone, and everything is going, or Android. It's on Android as well. And use your iPhone or Android, use it in your classroom, because it's more interactive, and they can go in the classroom or go outside and make patterns of everything they see in a shop or a wallpaper or whatever. I use shapes as well. I will show you my library. Here you can see the patterns, because I was I was playing with them. But I also use shapes. Something I draw early on. I made it a shape. I kept it out. I'm going to close one, because otherwise I think my computer won't work anymore. I had a saved copy as well, so. But yeah, I like the app, so I don't know, is anybody working with Captify yet or not?
So I think we had a couple comments in here. So Claudio said he loves Adobe Capture. If there's any more comments in the...
All right, I will show you a blank one, and then, yeah, you can use the shapes and start right away. But it's... Mm-hmm. I closed Illustrator. I have too much on my. Let's go to Photoshop. Oh, over here you can see the community art projects, and these are projects of my students. They are making the first assignment is a collage, and they had to be like rich and poor and something. Okay, I was opening the other one, and then my computer didn't open because I had too much on going on. But I will try it again. If you have a moment. Because I wanted to show you, keep in mind the first flat image of Illustrator. And then I'm going to show you what am I doing to make it from a flat image to a an artwork. Come. It won't work. Last try, and then I give up. Then I open the butterfly. Okay, here it is. I'll open my layer panel to talk you through it, through the process. And you can see that I have a lot of layers on top, beneath, a lot of textures. I'm using a lot of blending options, to make the artwork. These are the ones from Illustrator. So here is the flat image of Illustrator. And because I use a lot of textures, that's where you can make a lot of change in your artwork. So don't forget the blending modes. Everybody is forgetting them, or don't use them. But I use them all the time for every artwork I'm making. I'm always ending up with blending options and drawing and something else. Are there any questions?
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording now, and then we can move over to questions. But for those of you who are watching this recording, thank you so much, Karen, for joining us today and for sharing so much of your work. Have more questions? How can they get in touch with you? If through Education Exchange, or what would be the best method?
I was reading the chat, so I didn't hear your.
No, it's okay. So if you're on the Education Exchange, so if people who are watching the recording have questions, they can get in touch with you. And do you have any other, whether it's Twitter or email, what would be the best?
Oh yeah, I will type it in.
Perfect. Great. Well, thank you so much, Karen, again. And for those who are watching the recording, we will have our next creativity workshop with Hannah Messer on November 7th. So we look forward to seeing you during the next creativity workshop. Thank you for all that you do to support your students and fellow educators.
And was it enough, or was it too little?